Father's Day. A reminder that as you approach for communion, please use the hand sanitizers provided in order to keep both our community and our communion ministers as healthy as possible. Also, there is a QR code in the cover of your hymnal should you wish to make a contribution to the many parish ministries. As we prepare for our celebration, the numbers posted on the wall are to assist in your participation during this liturgy. Please turn to number 1225, 1225, as we take a few moments to read and reflect on the scriptures for today's liturgy. We quiet ourselves now in preparation for this Eucharist. In consideration of those seated near us, please take this opportunity to silence your cell phones.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, in today's gospel, Jesus tells us about the kingdom of God. He tells us two parables about seeds and growth and development. Just like our own lives, we too plant seeds and grow and develop throughout the course of our lifetime. So let us remember the past week and how God has called us to go beyond our comfort zones and respond to our neighbors. Lord Jesus, you teach us in story and parable. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you call us to plant seeds of justice and truthfulness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you gather all people into the harvest of the kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
The glory to God is number 399, 399.
Strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas, and grant us always the help of your grace, we who can do nothing without you. May we please you by our resolve and our deeds as we seek to follow your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches tear off a tender shoot, and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees that the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so I will do. The word of the Lord.
Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to make music to your name, O Most High, to proclaim your loving mercy in the morning, and your truth in the watches of the night. Lord, it is good to give thanks. The just will flourish like the palm tree and grow like a Lebanon cedar, planted in the house of the Lord. They will flourish in the courts of our God. Lord, still bearing fruit when they are old, still full of sap, still green, to proclaim that the Lord is upright. In him, my rock, there is no wrong. Lord,
a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow, he knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the grain is ripe, he wields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." He said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed, that when it is sown in the ground, it is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord. When I was a young boy, I was known for asking a lot of questions. I'd ask a question, I'd get an answer, and I'd ask another question. So often, members of my family would tire of that, they would give up and they would walk away, but I would be right on their heels asking more questions. Then when I became a teenager, I asked more serious questions, like deep thought-provoking questions about life, about death, questions about the universe, about the sky, about creation as a whole. And that's when I began to realize that clear, exact answers are not always to be found to life's more profound questions. So now, as an adult, I find myself trying to reconcile life and relationship with many unanswered questions. I have discovered that all our searching will never exhaust the many mysteries of life and relationship. But I still ask questions because I feel it's important that we continue to take delight in making new and fresh discoveries. And at the same time, I think we have to come to terms with not knowing. You know, not knowing is part of life's journey. Not knowing, though, should not diminish us or make us vulnerable or make us afraid, because God has all the power, and our searching can give God glory. You know, Jesus acknowledges the mystery that exists in the everyday experience of human life. He says that people are out there to help us, and especially the people that grow our own food. Between sowing the seed and the harvest, a great deal of activity goes on, which is invisible and not fully understood even. And I think that reminds us that there's a great deal in our world in which we do not fully understand today. But it's not reason for us to despair or throw our arms up and say, there's no hope. So using this parable of the seed growing secretly, Jesus appears to be saying that the kingdom of God is growing among us in many ways that we do not understand, just as the seed sown in the ground grows towards harvest in ways that we do not understand. I think there's a greater message here. It's a message that is reassuring. I think it's a hopeful message, because we're often tempted, I think, to give into this discouragement by the slow progress that the ways of God appear to be making in our world today. The spreading of God's reign is ultimately God's work. And that work is always underway, even when we do not see it or understand it, or even when we misunderstand it. We have a part to play in the coming of God's way of doing things among us, yes. But we're also warned against overestimating our role. You know, the scriptures say, neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who gives growth. God is always at work. And Jesus reminds us that God is at work in every situation and in every place, even those that seem very unpromising to us. So our hope can appear to diminish the size of a mustard seed at times. But the good news is this, that Jesus assures us that such hope is enough for the Lord to work with. You know, we have to learn to be content with the small seeds that we can sow and trust that we can bear fruit in ways that will surprise us. You know, my motto in life is this: be prepared to be surprised. You know, we can grow in our understanding. We can grow in our appreciation of little things and small gestures. Now, we may not feel called to be a hero or a martyr every day, but we are called to put a little dignity into each corner of our little world. I think there are little seeds of the kingdom that we can all sow: a friendly gesture, a welcoming smile, a sign of closeness to others, or a little ray of joy for those who are forlorn. Because God's reign comes into power through the seemingly insignificant actions of each one of us. You know, tonight, in keeping with the theme of seeds planted and growing, we are going to experience together the confirmation of two adults. It's a privilege that we as a parish family get to experience the confirmation of two wonderful people. So as I call the names of those to be confirmed in the Spirit, I ask them to come forward along with their sponsors and stand among the front step here. Ryan Ortiz and Regina Zion. Ryan and Regina, of your own free will, you have asked to be confirmed in the Catholic Church. You have made your decision after careful thought under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. I now invite you, in the presence of this community, to profess your faith along with us. And so I ask everyone now, please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please be seated. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed these children from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Joseph, be sealed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Adelaine, be sealed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. We celebrate with these two beautiful people their confirmation in the Spirit with applause. We come before the Lord now with our needs and our intercessions.
Our response is, God of love, hear our prayer. We bring before the Lord all the worries we have right now in our hearts and minds, for the many people in our homes and neighborhoods and world who might be in trouble at this moment in time. For the deceased Knights of Columbus from this parish for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
God of love, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who struggle to be faithful to their spouses, to their friendships, or their communities. We ask God's tender mercy upon who are tempted to give up. We pray to the Lord. For the exhausted, for the weak, and for all who suffer, may the loving hand of God cure the sick, raise the dead, and heal those who are plagued with disease. We especially lift up in prayer those from this parish family who are sick. We pray to the Lord. For leaders of nations and families and churches, may they lead with sincere hearts and listening ears. We pray to the Lord. For an end to bigotry, racial hatred, and ethnic violence,
May people everywhere be freed from ignorance and fear. We pray to the Lord. For each of us, may we be seeds planted in God's kingdom that bring hope to others during the upcoming week. By our example of service and faithfulness, we pray to the Lord.
God of power and might, you sent your Holy Spirit, the giver of life and gifts, for the good of your people. We open our hearts that all creation may be renewed by your joy and your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We sing together number 841, 841.
Oh,
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, whom the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sitting down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which we've given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis our Pope and James our Bishop and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in number 750, number 750.
For the fruits of all breathing.
us pray. Lord, as this reception of your Holy Communion foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring unity in your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for just a moment here. And now I'd like all fathers that are serving in the role of father to please stand. Yeah. Seeing that this is Father's Day weekend, we want to offer a very special blessing for all of our fathers here tonight. And we're going to pray this together, so you can find it on a white insert inside your hymnal. It's number 1495-1495, and we will offer this blessing together. So if you hold a right hand over a father near you, or a father that you want to bless, we'll bless you together. God of love, listen to this prayer. God of the holy ones throughout the ages, bend down your ear to this flock of upright men and bless them. Bless them with wisdom. Bless them with loyalty. Bless them with the ability to be gentle and caring toward others. When they are tugged by the many demands of life, bless these fathers with pride in their children. Bless them with a balance of work and play. Bless them with stable and responsible hearts. Today, God and parent of all your people, hear this prayer for all gentlemen who portray you in this present generation. This blessing we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And now everyone please stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to bring glory to our Lord.
Thanks be to God.